Shalom. This week's Torah portion is Sedra Vayigash. This week's Torah portion is heavy on drama. After hiding his identity for weeks, Yosef is unable to stand up to his brother Yehuda's emotional tirade about how poorly Yosef had been treating them. What did Yehuda say that pushed Yosef over the edge and forced him to reveal his true identity? As Yehuda gets into his speech, he reminds Yosef, "We told my Lord, we have an old father, and there's a child of his old age, the youngest. His full brother is dead, so that he alone is left of his mother, and his father dotes on him. Then you said to your servants, 'Bring him down to me, that I might set my eyes upon him.' We said to my Lord, 'The boy cannot leave his father. If he were to leave him, he would die.' But you said to your servants, 'Unless your youngest brother comes down with you, do not let me see your faces.'" There's a significant debate between our scholars about who Yehuda was talking about when he said that he would die if he came down. In his commentary to this pasuk, Rashi explained Yehuda was referring to Binyomin. If he leaves his father, we shall be in anxiety lest he die on the journey, because indeed his mother died during the journey. According to Rashi, the brothers feared that Binyomin would die from travel, just as Binyomin's mother had died. Their fear of dangerous travel is real. The Talmud recorded where Yehuda said that Rav said, "Four must offer thanks to God with a thanksgiving offering and a special blessing. They are people that travel the sea, those who walk in the desert, and one who was ill and recovered, and one who was incarcerated in prison and was released." Travel is objectively dangerous. The Bar Halacha wrote that one says the blessing upon reaching his destination, desert or ocean crossings, even if the trip was uneventful and no dangerous situation was experienced. But the Sforno disagreed with Rashi and understood Yehuda to mean not Binyamin, but their father, Yaakov, will die without question if Binyamin leaves him. The Sforno's explanation that Yehuda feared Yaakov would die without Binyamin is in line with something Yehuda said just a few psukim later. "When I come to your servant, my father, and the boy is not with us since Yaakov's soul is attached to Binyamin's soul." The Radak explained, due to the intense love that Yaakov has for this son, Binyamin, if he does not return with us, my father will die. Both we and you will have been guilty about bringing about his death. According to the Sforno, Yaakov's love for Binyamin was so great, the risk of Binyamin dying on a trip was too great to have him travel. Yaakov would be too devastated at the loss to live. The approach of the Sforno is in line with the teaching of Pirkei Avos. A love that is dependent on something, when the thing ceases, the love also ceases. But a love that is not dependent on anything never ceases. Love that isn't pure, that isn't dependent on something, is an extreme but ungrounded feeling. It's emotion run amok. That emotion is open to large swings, but true love is grounded in knowledge and appreciation of the subject of one's feelings. False love is a pure feeling lacking in appreciation of subject and is more likely focused on the benefits drawn by the lover and not on feelings for the subject of one's feelings. Facing Yehuda's emotional onslaught, demonstrating how Yosef had put his brother Binyamin at risk and risked torturing his father to death over the loss of yet another son, Yosef had to reveal himself. The lesson this episode teaches generations is the care and concern we must have for others. It isn't enough to not directly offend other people. We must also work to ensure our actions and demands don't indirectly hurt others. When Yosef realized he had caused indirect offense, he stopped and revealed himself. What a powerful message. Shabbat Shalom.